Okay guys, so sorry for looking a little scruffy, but today we are going to be talking about prepper basics or being prepared. In light of all these natural disasters that have been happening recently, I'm going to be going over just a few very basic preparations that you guys can make to help you keep or stay safe when the next disaster inevitably strikes. Before we get into this too much, I do also want to note that the type of prepping that I'm going to be talking about in this video is not the type of doomsday prepping that you see on Nat Geo. This isn't going to be talking about, you know, worst case scenario, if everything falls apart, here's a bunker to have and a million rounds of ammo. This is really more geared toward talking about having just practical preparations in store so that in case you lose power for 24, 48 hours, up to a week, or even a month, you can have the proper preparations in food, water, protection, those types of things is what we're going to be talking about in this video. We're not going to be going into like having a bunker, having a bug out vehicle, having, you know, a million rounds of ammo and backup. So that's not the type of video. If you're looking for doomsday prepping, this is not that video. This is just going to be small practical preparations. So with that out of the way, now let's get into my top five things. Okay, so now that we've got that out of the way, the first thing, and this is really going to be in no particular order because I kind of value these top five things as everything. Granted, in your own particular situation, you may find ammo or you may find food or you may find water to be of a higher value than food, or, you know, you're going to have to mix match these top five things and place them in an order of importance. I'm just rather stating them. So the first thing on the list, and like I said, it's in no order, is firearms. I think this is going to be a very important thing, and I should have really just said weaponry, and I'm not getting serious into this once again like doomsday prepping, but, you know, having a good, nice, defensive styled knife on hand, you know, having a good defensive rifle on hand with proper ammo, which we'll get into in just a moment, or, you know, having a good defensive handgun is going to be very important because, as we've seen, whether it's like Hurricane Katrina or whether it's even in this last fire in California, it's nothing extraordinarily crazy, but we do see an uproar or an insurgence of violence in these types of events and times. And so it's important, whether you're a business owner protecting your business or whether you're just simply defending your home, your property. For myself, you know, I have property, livestock that have to be defended at all costs. So it's important to have, you know, firearms like an AR-15 to be there and ready to defend those types of things, whether it's my loved ones or whether it's the property or the livestock that are on this property. So that's the first thing for me. Like I said, it's not necessarily ranking of importance. So the next thing is ammo, and this is a very important thing. Of course, if you're going to have a defensive rifle, you're going to need something, or a defensive handgun, whatever, you're going to need something to fuel that. Now, so this isn't a doomsday style prepping of having millions and millions of rounds of ammo, but rather just a practical amount, something like 500 rounds, because you'll be surprised how fast that ammo can go away, especially, like I said, if you're continually defending your property from looters or whatever. And so it's also important to have a good amount of ammo for, you know, hunting, and like I said, upwards of a month. If you are going without the ability to get food for upwards of a month, it's going to be important to have some means of getting food. So generally, ammo is the fastest way to achieve that by, you know, taking down game animals. And I'm not going to make recommendations of what style, or, you know, should you have hollow points, FMJs. Personally, for myself, I have a good mixture, about 50-50 of FMJs and hollow points for handguns, rifles, and that's because I would rather shoot a moose with a hollow point round, and I'd rather shoot through barriers with an FMJ. So that's kind of why I go with that, but that's just my own personal thing. That's ammunition and firearms out of the way. They are pretty important, and like I said, they are pretty important, and I would definitely recommend not, you know, taking them for granted or not stocking up on ammo, because when it comes to defending your life and your property and all that such stuff, things can be taken away very fast if you don't have the ability or means to defend them. So next, getting into some basic things again, is you want to have water, and I like having water in multiple different means, and a lot of it is in bottles, because I think bottles are some of the most versatile means of having water, but also having it in gallon or more like 5 gallon jugs is another great means of having water easily available to you. So I would highly recommend stocking up on things like water bottles and also gallon jugs, because if you need to wash yourself, or if you need to wash clothing, if you need to wash dishes, whatever, having a gallon jug as opposed to a whole bunch of these little water bottles is a little bit more helpful in that regard. So that is the next thing, and I think water, I will say, is definitely more important than food, because water you cannot live as long without, and is definitely a very high commodity. And I will say, everything that's being mentioned in this list, even if you don't have many intentions of shooting people or defending yourself, even just having firearms and ammo is a great commodity. If you need to trade, just a handful of bullets can buy you. You guys can see them. Handful of bullets. I can't really show them. Handful of bullets can buy you a meal in a type of situation like this. So, having things like bullets and ammo are a hot commodity in a natural disaster situation. So the next thing, of course, is food, and it's kind of a no-brainer of water and food. Of course, you need them to survive. Now, I will say I did rank food a little bit lower on my list, just because, one, you can live without it for a longer period of time, and two, it's the type of thing that you can pretty readily get, and it's not going to be as hard to get things like food, because you can go hunting as opposed to getting, firearms and ammo. I mean, in a type of situation like a disaster situation, firearms are going to be pretty coveted, so you're not going to have a very high chance of getting a gun unless you already have one from the get-go. So lastly, and I think one of the most important things, is having a good location or having a good shelter, something that brings warmth, something that brings protection, shelter, warmth, whatever that means to you. It doesn't necessarily have to be some illustrious house, but having something like tents, sleeping bags, having these types of things are very important to bring you, like I said, protection, not just from other people or other things, but from the elements. I mean, right now it's quite cold, and it's the middle of winter, not quite yet, but it's definitely winter time for us here in Alaska. So having protection from the elements is just as important, if not more important, than having protection from people or animals. So making sure you have something in place, whether that's, you're staying in your house and you have means to keep your house running and you have means of keeping your house defended, or if that means you have a bug out location that you go and you just set up, a tent or whatnot, make sure that you have something in that regard for protection, shelter, and warmth. So those are my top 5 things. Once again, this is primarily focusing on a situation of anywhere from, a week to a month, even, just a few days, like a 48-hour situation. And I realize that, there's definitely a lot of natural disasters happening, and it makes me think that Fairbanks especially is known for their power outages, known for a whole bunch of different, not necessarily huge, but natural disasters that can affect your way of life. So if you're not prepared for them in these small ways, it can actually really have a negative impact, because if you're without water, whether it's for a week or a month or even 4 days, it can kill you. So making sure that you have these adequate preps is very important. Anyways, guys, hope you've enjoyed this kind of prepper basics. That's all for now. God bless, and I'm out.